I have to say, there's no feeling of bereavement here, feeling of great joy and positive appreciation of what St. Bernard's has been to so many for so long, and so many former parishioners have come today. And I've had a great feeling of resurrection and life today. Even the hymn that Anne chose that we sung today, it's about life and hope. And our future is life and hope. The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
After John had been arrested, Jesus went into Galilee. There he proclaimed the good news from God. The time has come, he said, and the kingdom of God is close at hand. Repent and believe the good news. As he was walking along by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting a net in the lake, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you into fishers of men, women, children, everyone." And at once they left their nets and followed him. Going on a little further, he saw James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. He called them at once, and leaving their father Zebedee in the boat with the men he employed, he went after them. They went after him. This, the gospel of the Lord. Would you like to sit down, please? So my final words on St. Bernard's are a misstatement. That's fitting, I think. Now, children, you're going to take your children's Bible and the patterns.
Lay your
hand. No, Yinkin, right? You're our pet. Okay. Sylvia, taking the altar linen. You are much, thank you.
Render your peace.
Pete,
let them bring your
Immaculate.
Forgiveness and healing.
Lectionary for the special occasions. Gina's going to take the collecting bags. And Lil, you're going to come and you're going to bid us on our way.
Go in peace and love of God.
Thank you.
Neil. As I was talking about this last night, our fellow parishioner said she felt a great deal of sadness at the end of St. Bernard's. And yet we know it's not the end, we know it's the beginning. And it's so interesting, Francis had pointed out to me from today's gospel that as it began, it was John finished his ministry, then Jesus began his. The end of one and the beginning of another. John had had a most successful ministry, but then Jesus was to bring that and everything else to completion. And in the plan of God, we are to be help to bring God's plan to completion, you and I together. And here we are, just a fantastic group of people. But that witness, that procession, was a wonderful witness of faith. Today, when St. Paul clearly thought that the end was nigh and that things were coming soon, that if we thought that, say, this time next year, things were going to an end, come to an end, I wonder what we'd do with our lives. Maybe we'd know if we heard today and we'd immediately make peace with everybody we've ever been out of peace with and really be at rights with God. Well, if our journey together, it's really going to build up the reign of God. It means that the process of opening up to God and to each other, of looking how we can spread the reign of God, is something that must begin at this moment. And the beautiful thing is we take communion together. And all that means, the word communion literally means making one out of many. People coming together to form one incredibly beautiful community. And that is what we are, and we're going to become even more beautiful, and all for the glory of God. Let us stand for the Lord's Prayer. And could we express our bonds and unity by linking our hands together, not only with those who are next to us, but with people throughout this world, especially those yearning for companionship, for faith, for justice, for healing. In their name and in our own name we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us greet each other with the sign of peace.
Chris, Jerry and Barry. Andy, peace with you, sunshine.
Hello, Pat.
Oh, you're lovely, all of you, eh?
I know, yeah. I want to know Christy.
Christy, peace with you, thanks, sweetheart. Good answers, peace with you, darling. Peace with you, Werder. Peace with you. My dear friends, the rich and beautiful symbol of communion, bonded with Christ and bonded with each other, the body of Christ. God bless you, sweetheart. Joy is the body of Christ.
Amen.
Carry the body of Christ.
Amen.
Carry in the body of Christ. Weigh in the body of Christ. Dean, the body of Christ. Body of Christ, Pat. Sylvia, the body of Christ. Body of Christ, Tasha. Body of Christ, Pat. Body of Christ, Pat. Body of Christ, darling. Body of Christ, Iris. Being of the body of Christ. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glory in your gift, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I can't tell you how wonderful it has been for me, but I feel for everybody what could have been something so sad and miserable has in fact been a celebration of something incredibly beautiful. You know? And I can only say thank you to everybody. And indeed, as St. Bernard's were coming along, to see those lovely happy faces just at the corner of Crown Street and the park, and the lovely waves, Franco and Julie and everybody, it was really quite beautiful. Karen, it was just fantastic. And that really said, right, this is what is awaiting us. And so, here we are. So no longer, we don't speak of St. Bernard's anymore in terms of church or parish. It's now with the Church of St. Anne, and with the community of St. Anne, and with the worshiping community of St. Anne. And we've got so much that we're going to do together for the glory of God. Amen. Yeah. I'd like to say a special word of thanks to Lawrence and to Bernard, because they played their pipes leading the procession. And you know, I'm sure it made such a difference to us all. It really did. And it just sounded so special. And you know, it was a wonderful witness to what we believe in and to who we are and what we are. So praise God. So I just, in thanking everybody, it's for so many things.
Can I just say something?
Yes?
It's 30 years tomorrow that Father Peter first came into St. Bernard's, and I was sitting on the front row with my daughter and the baby.
Oh, yes.
And I'd just like to give him a round of applause, because he's been the most wonderful priest at St. Bernard's.
Thank you. Let's pray for the renewal of our parish.
Father, can I say one thing?
Our oldest parishioner, who is 97, wishes to say something.
I just want to say, you know, there's been sadness for me after being 90.